in rap shit so fake, bro. It's so many fake friends up in this shit. Like, I say, even like, say, man, bro, when Dog died. Like, you ain't see a lot of rappers say nothing about bro. You feel me? Like, it was to the minimum, like, you feel me? Like, that, I feel like that was fake as fuck. Cause when y'all niggas see, bro, y'all be on it deep. Like, I done literally seen niggas in the jewelry store with bro, they be on it deep. Niggas ain't even say R.I.P. to Dog, but Virgil died. The nigga over the Louis Vuitton, I mean, what, the all-white shit and the Louis Vuitton, like, design, nigga. Like, R.I.P. to Virgil, no disrespect, but the whole motherfucking rap game posted Virgil. Then half of them niggas posted Dog. I ain't understand that. I wasn't feeling that shit. Mm-hmm. I think that shit was fake as fuck.
There you have it. That boy Bankroll Freddy coming straight up out of Arkansas, man. He was close friends with that boy Young Dolph. You know, they did a few songs together, whatever, but Dolph was one of his biggest, you know, idols or whatever, man. He really, really did rock with that boy Dolph, but he made a very, very interesting point, what he just said. He said a lot of rappers, when Dolph died, they showed their true colors. They wouldn't even post RIP. And, you know, they just basically, you know what I mean, act like, you know, it was just another day in the hip-hop world. But then when Virgil died, you know, the dude from Louis Vuitton, the fashion designer, icon guy, everybody was RIP Virgil, RIP Virgil. Virgil this, Virgil that, the whole rap game. And Bankroll Freddy said he felt like that was fake because a lot of these same people, when they seen Dolph in real life, you know, they was, you know, kicking it and, you know, giving that fake love, acting like they rock with him and things of this nature. So he make a very valid point. But the one thing he failing to realize is that with the Young Dolph situation, a lot of them rappers, they didn't post Dolph because they was trying to stay neutral and kind of play both sides of the fence with the whole Paper Route versus CMG thing. Because a lot of rappers, they in the back of their mind, they felt like Yo Gotti them had something to do with it. So they felt like if they give their condolences or say RIP to Dolph, then they felt like that would be a sign of them picking sides or choosing sides. And a lot of them, they didn't want to be categorized in choosing sides or picking sides. They did not want to, you know, get caught up in that right there. So that's why a lot of rappers chose not to post Dolph or say RIP to Young Dolph, because they didn't want to, you know, ruin their relationships to CMG, nor did they want to make it seem like they was, you know, on Paper Route side of the equation. You know, now here it is, after the fact, you know, nobody from CMG has been arrested for this murder. They got Straight Drop and a couple of these other guys that affiliated with him charged with this murder. And it looked like nobody from CMG is going to be charged with this murder. But at the time of the death, the rap gang, they didn't know that. A lot of people was automatically assuming that CMG was responsible for this assassination. So they really was just, you know, just trying to stay neutral. And I kind of understand people for wanting to stay neutral, not pick side, not choose side when it come down to real life beef and real life smoke, you know. But Freddie, he letting it be known, like, man, look, man, if this my partner, this my dog, if he die, you know, I got a rep for him. You know what I'm saying? He got a song called Long Live Dog. Gucci got a song called Long Live Dog. And these are the people that's really, that was down for Dolph for real. These are Dolph real true friends. And like he said in the rap game, it is a lot of fake friends, because a lot of them people that's in the rap game, they wasn't really friends with Young Dolph for real. You know, they were just, you know, dick pulling and dick riding when he's around, hoping to get a free feature or, you know, some things of that nature. But in true reality, they really wasn't down with Young Dolph for real, because the whole rap game is fake. You know, people be trying to be cool with everybody. They be smiling in everybody's face, especially the guys that they feel like got a bigger bag than them. And Young Dolph, he was a person who had a bigger bag than most of the rappers that he's around. So most of the rappers that he's around, they're going to smile in his face and try to act like they cool with him. You know what I'm saying? Because they just dick ride, you know what I'm saying? Hoping that, you know, Dolph will give him something free or give him a shout out or just do something for their music career. You see what I'm saying? But genuinely, them folk, they did not give a damn about Young Dolph, whether he live or whether he died. They didn't care nothing about Young Dolph for real. And there's a few people that did, like the people on Paper Route, as well as Gucci Mane, as well as Bankroll Freddy, and other people that genuinely did have love and admiration for Young Dolph. But the majority of the rap gang, they really didn't. And that it showed itself, and that's basically what he's speaking on. Sporty Black Man, if you're new to the channel, hit that sub button. Feel free to comment below and let me know what y'all feel about this whole situation, you know, about the rap game and people being fake and showing fake love and people not posting Young Dolph, you know, but still want to post Virgil and things of this nature. Hit the like button. Share the video, man. On Sporty Black, we grinding for 20K, man. I'm gone.